Jonathan from Rain Brothers here, rainbrothers.com. Today we're going to talk about creating an underground reservoir for a low flow, low yield well. Now, we've talked about creating an inside reservoir before, like a basement tank for a low flow well. That is the most cost effective route to go, but sometimes you need more in storage than just a 500 gallon basement tank. And in that case, it oftentimes makes sense to install a large underground tank outside, route that well water in there, have a reservoir, and then also have the ability to haul in, to truck in water if your well just isn't producing enough. So this video is going over a recent install that we did. We installed a 2,500 gallon concrete tank, one of our precast concrete cisterns, and intercepted that well and really were in and out in one day for this person. We completely switched their water supply and gave them a whole new water system that is much more reliable. And here's exactly how we did it. First thing we did was dig our pit, and we wanted to keep close to the well, but not too close. In this case, about 15 feet from the existing well. From there, we dig a trench from the house. This is going to be a trench for the new cable that's going to supply the new pump inside the cistern. Here's our existing well. You can see the cable inside the well casing. That's for the existing well pump. We're going to find that cable underground, and hopefully that water line that's coming out of the well will be right with in the same trench as the cable. So here we are digging a trench alongside the well to locate that wire going from the house to the well, and also that water line. And if you look at the trench, you can sometimes see where it's been backfilled. It looks different than the virgin ground around it. And you can see that crumbled area looks like it's been backfilled. That's likely where our water line is going to be. So we dig carefully. Wow. Luckily, digging with the excavator, we had a spotter, saw the cable, and then hand dig down to find the water line. Now we're setting the concrete tank. That's a 2,500 gallon tank. And in the meantime, we did find the water line and installed two 90 degree fittings in the water line. So we cut out a section and sprayed it with pink tape so that if the trench got backfilled or dirt caved in, we'd be able to find it easily. To illustrate this another way, here's our well casing right here. Here's the submersible pump down in the well. The black line is the water line going to the house. The red is the power coming up from the pump, out the top of the casing, back down into the trench, into the house. What we're doing is we're finding this water line and the power line. We're going to find it, cut a section out, and install a line going to the cistern and a line coming from the cistern going to the house. So the flow is, well, we're putting in a 90 here, running the water line to the cistern, flowing in to fill the cistern, and then coming out of the cistern from the new pump in the tank, we're going to supply the water line to the house. All we have to do that is cut out a section and install a 90 here and a 90 here. With the wire, we're going to do something similar. We're looking in the same trench. We found the cable. There's three wires inside that cable. This is what's called a two-wire pump. It's a 230-volt pump. So we have a hot wire, a second hot wire, and a ground. All we're doing is going to intercept one hot wire, and we're going to do the exact same thing with the wire that we did with the water line. We're going to cut one of the hot wires, bring that to the cistern. One of the hot wires is going to go into one side of the float switch, and then we're going to take the other side of the float switch and return it back to this wire. So we're intercepting this one of the hot wires, one side going to the float switch here, the other side is returning and continuing to the house. All we're doing is putting in a switch in this cable that will tell the pump to turn on and off based on the water level in the cistern. And here you can see what that looks like when we installed it. We cut out about 8 inches of the cable and put in 2 UF splice kits so that we could run, we could interrupt one of the hot legs of the cable. So we're running those 2 conductors to the cistern tank, and that's going to tie into our float switch in the tank. We now have the top half of the concrete tank set and we're vacuum testing. We've got a plate on to make sure that the tank is watertight, airtight. And now here is the new cable. This is the power supply going to the new pump that's inside the cistern tank. We need to run that all the way back to a pressure switch inside the basement. So here that blue wire is still on the spool there. We're going to run that all the way to the cistern tank. Here we got a water truck filling the newly installed tank. That's the supply line on the left coming out of the cistern pump. That's the water line there that's going to supply the house. And that is the supply line going into the tank to fill it from the well. So the one on the left is well feed filling the tank. One on the right is continuing water line to the house to supply newly pressurized water from the cistern. Returning to the board, let's illustrate this. So again, we have our old water line from the well feeding the cistern to fill it. We have a new pump installed inside the cistern, and that water line ties right back into the old water line, which we cut out a section, put in a 90 degree fitting, tied in. So all this was already existing, going all the way back to the pressure tank in the basement. All that's already in place. We just intercepted it right here. On the wiring, we have 3 wires coming out, 3 conductors coming out of the well. This is a 230 volt pump. So we have a ground, we have 1 hot leg and a 2nd hot leg. And all we did was cut into one of the hot legs of that cable, brought, just intercepted it and ran that hot leg through this float switch in the tank, a normally closed float switch, and then back around to continue that power supply. Now, this power supply used to be tied into a pressure switch on the pressure tank. We're actually going to remove that cable from the pressure switch, and instead, we're going to run it into our pump saver, our little fuse pump saver. That's going to detect if the well is drawing air, which often happens in a case of a low yield well. If that well starts to draw air, that pump saver is going to detect that drop in amperage and will shut the pump off automatically and restart it at a given interval so that it allows the well to recharge and it's not running the pump dry. So we're removing the wiring from the pressure switch. This existing wiring, this red wire, is already existing. We're removing it from the pressure switch, moving it to the pump saver, and then running the circuit from the pump saver, tying it into a dedicated breaker at the panel. That new blue cable that we laid is going to go from the new cistern pump that we just installed, and that we're going to run into the house, and we're going to run that into the existing pressure tank and wire it into the pressure switch. And then that pressure switch is already run to a dedicated breaker in the electrical panel. So we don't have to do anything there, although we will want to make sure we're using the same voltage pump. as was already installed. So if this well pump was a 230 volt pump, we want to use a 230 volt pump here so that we don't have to change out the breaker in the panel. So this is already going to be energized. We're just going to run that new blue cable all the way to the pressure switch. So now we have everything hooked up. Let's test out the system. Our float switch is in place. We lift it up, let that float switch drop, and it activates the well immediately. And the well line is charging the cistern just like it should. We drop the float switch back in the water. It raises the float switch, stops the well, and we have a functioning system. I really hope this has been helpful. I know it gets a little confusing. There are some changes. If you have a well pump that's higher than horse and a half, 1.5 horsepower, please reach out to us because there are some changes that you need to make from this design that we just laid out. We have a low yield well reservoir kit on our website, very affordably priced. It contains all the parts you need to install a system like this, minus the tank. And there are many more videos that will help aid every aspect of this installation. I have them all linked in the description below. Please like and subscribe for more videos just like this that go into great detail on getting a quality water system for your house. Thank you.